Hey guys, welcome back to Electrical Car Repair Live. In today's video guys, we are going to review a Mercedes. A 2014 Mercedes C250 guys. We are going to explain what we like about this car, what we don't like about this car, and if it's worth the money or not. If you want, you can check it out. It's on Auto Repair guys. We have how much we paid for it. Okay, this is the channel and how much it cost us. All that stuff. Now, in today's video review guys, we're going to explain what mileage we get, what it comes with, and things we don't like and things we like. So, as a whole, it's a really, really good car. Now, it's a little bit expensive in my opinion. Trunk is not too small, but it's not great big either. Okay, it comes with a spare tire, so that's a big hit, because most new vehicles don't even come with a spare tire nowadays. So, that's a big advantage. Spare tire, you have emergency kit in the back. Now, let me show you the interior. Check it out. I have the key in my pocket and I can unlock the doors just by touching the door handle. Also, I can lock the door, okay, by touching the door handle too. Or I have to be far away, we'll see how that works. So, really clean design, really, really good looking car. Seats are comfortable, but you don't have that sport feeling. Even though it has the sport package, they're not like the deep Recaro seats like BMW uses. BMW seats are a little bit better in my opinion. Inside, it's really, really nice, comfortable. It's a quiet car, you don't hear any road noise. Has sunroof. So, everything is like it should be. Let me show you. Push start button here. That was an extra. But you can actually even remove that thing. Okay, and not use it. You can use a regular key or you can use the push start button. Okay. Perfect. Now that's ready for Bluetooth connection. Now let me go through the screen and show you what we have here. You can have phone ready, navigation, radio, you can change stations. Okay, you can check your current fuel consumption, range, fuel mileage and all that stuff. Now, how much fuel that thing uses, guys? On the highway, we two people, we get over 30 miles to the gallon with no problem, 32 mpg. With four people driving a little bit fast, probably about 75, 80, it gets about 27, 28. Now, another thing about it is, the way I drive it, the average is about 25, 26. Because it has a little bit of city driving, some highway driving as well, and all that stuff. The screen is nice, but it's not as easy to use as you would think. Okay, it could be a little bit easier to use and navigate. But as a whole, not bad. Now, you can go to radio, here, audio, and click again. We have different stations and all that stuff. However guys, okay, that thing, connecting your phone takes a little bit of time. You have to read the manual because it's not as straightforward as you will think it is. Okay, I have mine connected Moto G5 Plus here. And not bad, but I mean, it's not as easy as you think. The car does drive super nice, super good on the highway. Okay, and it has the blind spot detector on the side. Okay, you can see the mirrors, so if there is somebody here, it turns red while you're driving. It's going to tell you as well. And it has the lane assist as well. Okay, the lane assist, the camera is actually right here, the sensor. And if you leave your lane, the steering wheel starts vibrating, it will warn you as well. That coffee cup, if you drive for a long time, it tells you to stop and take a break. It notices when you're tired. So, really, really cool thing. But think about it, most newer vehicles come with those options now. Even a Hyundai Elantra for like $17,000, brand new one, comes with those options. So, that's not too big of a deal. Engine runs good. It's pretty quick. Nothing super fast, but it's quick enough to get you to the speed. Probably 0 to 60, it's in about 7 point something seconds. That's how it feels. The steering wheel feels a little bit light in my opinion. BMW steering wheel is more, tight. You feel the road better. With this one, it's kind of like driving a little bit like a Cadillac. You don't feel the road so good. Engine it's turbocharged, as you know, 1.8 turbocharged. Easy to work on, not too complicated of an engine. You can see the turbo is on this side, right here. That's your turbo. You remove the cover, you have your ignition coils, direct fuel injection, that's your computer for the engine here, easy location, throttle body. Most of the stuff that are serviceable are easy to access. You still have an old dipstick. Remember BMW, they don't even have a dipstick that year. So, as a whole guys, good car. And I think it's really worth the money, but depending on what you like and what you don't like. Now, in my opinion, I like BMWs a lot better too, so I like Mercedes as well, but this one feels more like a not so much of a fun vehicle, more like a classy vehicle, to be honest with you. More like, you know, going to a meeting or something like that. Not like you're going to take this thing to the racetrack. But it's not made for that anyway. So hopefully the video will be helpful to some of you guys. See what we like, what we don't, and see you guys next time.